comments related to various board situations, comments they might have had some questions for the player representatives.
And Paul, we've had a couple of really good examples of sports adapting to the new situation and using kind of e-sports. Do you reckon we could see a Tour de France, a virtual Tour de France?
Well, there's the challenge. Cycling has actually had one race already that looks to replicate a European race. It was a one-day event. Michael Matthews, the Australian, competed in that. He said that that might happen.
Spread the virus even when you don't have symptoms. Our best defense is sticking to the tried and true.
And the IMF forecasts COVID-19 will lead to the worst economic downturn since the Great Depression. Taking a quick look at the weather first in the capital cities around the nation today. Brisbane mostly sunny, Sydney and Canberra sunny, Melbourne partly cloudy, Hobart rain developing, Adelaide cloud increasing, Perth possible shower, and Darwin mostly sunny. The Australian market has retreated from the 1 month high. We'll check the figures in more detail on later sooner. News Corp journalist Anna Smithhurst has won her High Court battle against a police search of her home in Canberra last year. The search was triggered by allegations that classified information had been revealed in stories that were published a year before, suggesting plans to expand the scope of the Australian Signals Directorate to spy on citizens within Australia. Reporter Matthew Dorman has brought the
High Court. It was a unanimous ruling by the High Court, however, the judges have differed somewhat in the outcome when it comes to what happens to that data that police have seized from Anna Smithhurst's home and from her personal phone. What happened here is that all seven judges decided that they, in their unanimous judgment, that the warrant itself was invalid. Now, there are a few reasons for that. They say that it misstated the offence itself under the Act. The government's lawyers, in challenging and responding to Anna Smithhurst's appeal, had said throughout this case that it was enough for the police, the Australian Federal Police, to say in general terms what the crime that Miss Smithhurst was believed to have been party to was, rather than going into the specific details. The High Court today has found that no, that wasn't the case. They have also found that there wasn't enough precision in the drafting of that warrant, so the whole warrant itself should be quashed. In other words, it no longer has any legal meaning. The other argument that was being looked at by the High Court was whether or not the laws themselves, the Crimes Act and the law that allowed police to obtain this data from Anna Smithhurst, breached the implied right to freedom of political communication in Australia. The court found that because the warrant itself was invalid, that they didn't actually have to go into that constitutional matter, so they said it was unnecessary for them to find an outcome in that part of the High Court case. So that judgment handed down just a short time ago here at the High Court. All of the justices are as well having to deal with the issue of coronavirus. They are delivering that judgment across three different cities via video link, and the judgment just handed down that Anna Smithhurst's warrant used to search her home back in June last year has been quashed by the High Court.
Is it clear what the police were doing with the material that they seized from Anna Smithhurst's house? Were they prevented from opening and going through that while this case was going to the High Court? And do they now have to hand those documents back to Anna Smithhurst without having looked at them? What happens on that front?
So while the appeal was happening here in the High Court, the AFP were not able to look at those documents. They did agreed not to be looking at that data as part of their investigation into the leaks. This is the interesting part here, and it could mean that there are further hearings on this matter over the next few weeks and months. The court didn't come to a consensus as to how to deal with that data. A number of the judges said that a USB with that data that was seized from Ms. Smithers and from her computers and the like should be given back to her, along with technical instructions as to how to delete those documents. And the AFP agrees that they have their own internal systems, but that was only the review of a few of the judges. Not all of them decided to go that far. So this could become a situation where there are more court hearings while there are arguments as to what to do with that data. Certainly the federal government have been saying that in their submissions behalf of the Australian Federal Police that in the event that they were unsuccessful, that this warrant was ruled invalid, that that document, that data, should be allowed to be kept by the police for future prosecutions. It hasn't quite been a clear outcome on that one. So we'll wait to see how that plays out over the coming weeks, and with everything in the legal profession, like over the coming months.
Yeah, and so it doesn't appear to be the case, definitely, that this investigation is dead in the water now.
No.
Okay, we'll just leave that there because the Tasmanian Premier Peter Cutman's just went up for a media conference.
Thank you. chatted with Emily, who is a worker at wasn't working at the North West Regional Hospital, will be again when that hospital reopens. And Emily made the point that she was comforted by the fact that the government was acting swiftly, comforted by the fact that steps were being taken, albeit extreme in the fact that we have put nearly 4,500, well, between 4,000 and 5,000 people into quarantine. Comforted by the fact that the cleaning of the hospital will be underway, and comforted by the fact that the ADF and the hospital were coming in to help and ensure that we could provide the services that we need. But she explained to me how difficult it was to 11 days ago, actually as one of the first staff to be furloughed, to actually say goodbye to her two young children and to her husband as she went into quarantine as a result of the concerns regarding the outbreak at that time. And the conversation that we had last night was in relation to the challenges that all of our health care workers on the North West Coast now face as a result of some of the social media traffic, some of the key rules. This is probably the most difficult part of my job, to stand here and explain that six Tasmanians